Hello there. Hope you're doing well. It's Wednesday, August 7th, 2024, and I hope you're doing well. There's several things going on, as you know, and I'm praying about a lot of it. I may just mention names. I may just mention situations, and to let you know that we're praying about these things. The situation in Israel, God forbid, Iran attacks Israel. I bind it in the name of Jesus. That's Psalm 83. And this horrible hell going on in the UK, I'll mention this and know that I'm praying about it, and I bind a jihad and all the lies of certain things that cause people to attack people, and this horrible stuff, you know, killing little children at a dance studio or whatever, three little girls, apparently, I'm not sure on that exact quote on that, but and then the officials in the UK, you know, they don't even, they're putting people in jail for making a comment on Facebook about something. And, you know, this, all this stuff, I'm mentioning some just words, and just say your amens if you are in agreement with me that this is horrible hell. And we come against it in the name of Jesus, this attack, these attacks in the UK from certain people against other people because they have a certain lie of thinking in their brain from a certain situation. Now I got to talk in circles, because if you don't talk in circles, you know what I'm saying, God will interpret for you, the Holy Spirit will interpret all this for you, and He does, and He will. And, you know, we're just talking here. But if you say certain things, and if you say certain things in a certain way, just, you know, I mean, just let's just stay gaslit, okay? Let's just say gaslit. And but I'm not saying I'm just staying gaslit in certain areas. Anyway, let me just read the word, because the word of God is supernatural. The word of God can cut through all the BS, all the hell, anything on earth, anything in the heavens. God's word can cut through all of it. And we don't even have to hardly lift a finger, okay? So we send your word, Lord, and we thank you for your word. And I happen to be in, I'm just following my little schedule I have all along. I just try to stay focused and have a little schedule. Sometimes I go off schedule, and that is totally okay, because, you know, that way we're a little more free. But anyway, let's just stick with the program in many ways, and I just pray for you and yours and all of our friends, family, loved ones, our cities and towns, regardless of who's in charge, Democrats or Republicans, regardless of who's running for any candidacy, because obviously, and behind the scenes, the deep state, and they're usually Democrat, deep state Democrats, that they think they're God, they think they're holier than thouest, and that they know better than everybody and anybody. And this is not really America, okay? They've taken over America, and we're just now finding out about it. But anyway, the word of God is not to, God's hand is not too short that it cannot save, and he will go into these areas where we have no idea where they're at. We have no idea who they are. Let's just stay calm and trust God every single day, and we give him praise and glory. Confess your sins, get Jesus in your heart. I come into my heart, Lord, always be ready. And he knows, he's way more merciful than we are. God is way more merciful than we could ever imagine. So just come to him by faith. You come to him like, okay, you come to him like he's right there in front of you. God, just pretend, fake it till you make it. Okay, faith. faith is God is right there. God is right there. God is everywhere. God is God. God, we exalt you, God. We praise your holy name. And God has a son named Jesus that he sent into this world. He's the Messiah. He came to save us. And he died on a cross for our sins. And if we will acknowledge him in our hearts, just even a tiny bit of faith, believing that, and start talking to him. It's not nutty to talk to God, okay? Now, they might try to pin that on you, but you can talk to God while you're driving in the car. And, you know, when you think somebody might be looking at you from another car, you can just praise the Lord. Just thank you, Jesus. Talk in tongues. You can speak in tongues, and they don't even know what you're doing. So we're not going to be acting like fools. You can go into a dentist's office. And, you know, I just love real life. I love being real in real life, okay? When you go to the gym, when you go to the store, we're not into politics and all this stuff. We just treat each other with respect and love. And we bind the devil from rising up with his evil, crime, criminal, unmerciful harm to people. Witchcraft, we bind you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. We cast you out, down, and under our feet in the name of Jesus. Protect us, Lord. It's simple. God wants us to be protected. God wants us saved. God wants us protected. God wants us healed. God wants us delivered. God wants us blessed like heaven on earth, like the Garden of Eden. And we take what is rightfully ours, Lord, in the Spirit, and we believe you. We thank you, Holy Spirit. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for moving in this earth, saving people, delivering people. These people out there that are doing this crime, we pray you'll take them by the shoulders, just take them, arrest them in the Spirit, shake this out of them, deliver them, bring them to their right mind. Help them realize, just help them calm down and provide every need, Lord. Help them repent of their thinking. Repent of their thinking of jihad. Repent, 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 repent. Stop it. Stop it. Harm is bad and evil, and it's of the devil. Harming people, okay? Now, and God has shown you that this is the truth. This is true for everybody. Everybody knows this. Everybody knows it's stupid and evil and wicked and what the hell, excuse my language, Tim Walz of governor of Minnesota and any other governor or anybody anywhere putting tampons in a boy's bathroom is straight from stupidity. And why would you do that? So you can condition little boys about sex, because they're going to ask questions, aren't they? They're going to say, what are these for? You're a sick F. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me. And he has been chosen by Kamala Harris, Vice President of the United States of America, installed by the soft coup. It's not really soft, it was pretty bold. They've removed Joe Biden from the campaign and installed without any votes. And they talk about the Republicans. Oh, they're going to take away our democracy. They're going to take away our democracy. Oh my God. the Republicans, horrible Republicans, they're going to take away all of our democracy, when they have no democracy. When they have no democracy, they are not at all anywhere near democracy, Democrats. Democrats. Okay, now I'm going to get off my little rant here. Calm down. Psalm 31, in thee, O Lord, do I put my trust. Yes, Lord. In thee, O Lord, do we put our trust. In thee, O Lord, right here in front of us, God Almighty. In thee, O Lord, and he's up there too. And if I make my bed in Sheol, he is there. He is everywhere. Okay? God Almighty, and he has a son named Jesus that died for our sins. He sent him to be the perfect sacrifice to take away the sins of the world. Okay? And we've all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. In thee, O Lord, do I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. He has taken our shame. He has forgiven our sins, and he has taken our shame. And all you have to do is step over that line by faith into what he's already done for you, if you haven't already. Okay, that's, and he's practical. God is a practical God. Okay? I don't know. I could talk and talk and talk about religion versus what I'm talking about right now, and you know what I'm talking about. But anyway, God's word is so powerful. We lift up everybody we love. We lift up the children, the states, the counties, the cities, the neighbors, the neighborhoods. We continue to come against crime and accidents and close calls in the home and out of the home, in the cars, trucks, boats, trains, planes, you name it. In thee, O Lord, do I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in thy righteousness. It's his righteousness, not mine. It's his not righteousness, not ours. We don't have to feel like we are better than thouest, than anybody, just because we have Jesus. Okay, we don't have to look down on people and go, well, you don't have the Lord, so, and you're Jewish, so you must be my enemy. No. Okay? Stop it. Stop it. And I'm not telling you what to do, really. I'm really not telling you what to do, okay? I'm really not telling you what to do. Bow down thine ear to me, yes, God. Bow down thine ear to me. Deliver me speedily. Yes, Lord, be thou my strong rock, for a house of defense to save me. For thou art my rock and my fortress, therefore for thy name's sake, lead me and guide me. Pull me out of the net. We intercede for President Trump. You know, they have a net set for him still over there in New York City, I believe. And you know, the people in Georgia and Arizona are trying to put people in jail and prison and charge them and subpoena them and charge them for these phony charges because somebody objected to something. And I won't say it's the forbidden word to say. Where people go and they make a mark and they choose who they want to choose to be in politics and as leader. Okay, that thing, the forbidden word that we shall not talk about. And you know, praise the Lord, thank you Jesus, pull me out of the net that they have laid privily for me. And even Israel, I bind you demons from hell in Iran. I bind Hamas. They have a new leader now. Hamas has a new leader since the other one was, you know, sent to his virgins a few days ago. For thou art my strength, into thine hand I commit my spirit. Jesus said that on the cross. And we say it to God, into thine hand we commit our spirits. Thou hast redeemed me. Thou hast redeemed me. Thou hast. Jesus has redeemed us. He's the Redeemer. He is the Redeemer. Go look up a song. I forget the name of the artist, the singer, beautiful black girl. My Redeemer. Look that up and watch that video on YouTube, I believe. Hopefully it's still there. My Redeemer. Beautiful song, beautiful girl, beautiful sister in the Lord. O Lord God of truth, I have hated them that regard lying vanities. Don't you hate the lies they tell? Don't you hate the lies that you're hearing from even this new pick for Vice President, Tim Wahl, the governor of Minnesota, lying about his military, just weird stuff. Actually, weird, creepy stuff. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. And you know what? He's not the only one. Where else are there? Have they allowed tampons in boys' bathrooms? I bind this crap from hell in Jesus Christ's holy name. I will be glad and rejoice in thy mercy, for thou hast considered my trouble. Thou hast known my soul in adversities. And I just confess, I can't sometimes get the description of my whole video on my video. So please just forgive me for the lighting is bad. My hair is bad. Everything, I'm not going to condemn myself, but no, the lighting is bad, but it is what it is. So I work with what I work with, okay? I work with what I have. And I praise God, it's okay. It's okay. I will be glad and rejoice in thy mercy, for thou hast considered my trouble and thou hast known my soul in adversities. This is so good. It goes down to, it's so long, I don't need to read the whole thing. I'd love to, but you can read for yourself down 24 verses, okay? And praise your holy name, Lord. Anything else that we miss that we need to pray and agree on, we pray for our infrastructure. We come against the flooding, the hurricanes, the tornadoes, the huge earthquakes. We bind. God said there will be earthquakes in the last days. Okay, we get it. But we bind the huge ones. We bind the big ones. We take authority over the big ones, okay? And I used to say in populated areas, but little population areas. I mean, we don't need destruction from these things. And on earth as it is in heaven, I know some of you are going to look at this video and think I'm a wacko, Wacko Wanda. That's okay. That is totally okay, all right? God bless you. And many of you don't agree with many of the things I say, or me, or just me getting on a video and talking about God and the Word, because I'm a woman, of course, too. That's just OMG. Forbidden. Okay, well, whatever. That's your problem. I'm going to obey God. Are you going to obey God? Now, don't get destructive here, because God is a good God, and I bind your destruction. If you're a Christian and you're destructive, I bind your destructive thinking, because that's what we don't like about other so-called religions, isn't it? That's what we complain about, right? That's what we know is bad and evil, and oh, that's not God. They're serving a different, they're not serving the correct God. And then we get over into some of that ourselves. And some people, it can trigger people, God forbid, it triggering people. But you believe something so strongly that you are so full of hate O ye Christian, so-called Christian. Maybe you're not a Christian. Maybe you need Jesus. Maybe you need to repent of your anger and rage and your hate that you have harbored, hate and unforgiveness. Things happen in life and you don't even realize your part in it. Things happen in life. Things happen in life all the time, and people just move on. They get on with their life. They know they messed up, and they know that God has forgiven them. They know they just got to move on, and they messed up, and that's okay, well, whatever. You know that word, S-H-I-T, happens? I'm trying not to say the words, but you've heard that before, right? And people, normal people, and it happens all the time. We all make mistakes. Maybe we've made mistakes, and maybe you think it wasn't a mistake. And maybe you think the person that thinks it was a mistake. And yet some mistakes that we make, some amazing things come out of some of the so-called mistakes we've made, okay? Some of the amazing things that have come out of some of the mistakes we have made, so-called mistakes. And God works it all out. And God is love. And so much good has come out of some of the mistakes. I'm not saying all. And yeah, we pay a price. You shall reap what you sow. But just realize, just confess your sins and ask Him to forgive us. Forgive you. Forgive us, Lord. We confess right now. We have sinned. We have sinned. We forgive each other, Lord. We forgive each other. Bless our enemies, Lord. Bless those that persecute us. We block the devil. We block harm. You know, you have something that you don't like about somebody that's pretending, or they say they're somebody and they're really not somebody. They say, and then you think you can just go take care of the problem yourself. No, I bind that crap right now. You're on some of these self-righteous apps that have arrived to the Thou Most Holiness. And you have you're on your little app, on your little mountain of your holier than thou app, and you look at some people and you got this group, you know, you're on there with other so-called self-righteous. Now, I'm not condemning you. Go for it. You're up on your little mountain in your little app, so to speak. You know, where you're holier than thouest, and then you look at some people in life that they haven't arrived at all. They haven't even crossed over into the train for the arrival train, you know, confessing Jesus or whatever, repenting of their sins, you know, and we look down at them, and there's lots of people out there that are in that situation, okay? And our world is full of people like that. And then there's people in other countries, they won't put up with some of this stuff, you know. And so we think that we have arrived, and so we, you know, think we're going to go take care of this problem. There are some people God forbid they get a hair up their little ass about a politician they don't like. And I come against this evil, assassination attempts, or even from the deep state who blah, blah, blah. I rebuke you, Satan. I bind you. I bind your false flags, red flags, false flags. You know, things get too calm, and you just can't stand that things are too calm. So you think you gotta cause some havoc in the world, in the earth, in our country. Because you are in charge. You are getting paid by the government to do what you want to do. And you're up there in your holy hill up there, and whatever, NSA 17 divisions of the blah, blah, blah. And we have arrived, and we are the ones in charge here. We haven't been elected, but we are the ones that are in charge. And somebody's running the show. Who's running this show? Who is running this show? Is it Biden? Oh, who's running the show? Who have you crowned the King of Kings? Now Jesus is the King of Kings. Okay, so don't forget that while you're on your little holy Hillary? Hillary and O'Biden? Hillary and Obama? Who have you crowned to be your leader and making the decisions behind the scenes? Who is it? Who is it? Now, I'm not saying it's Obama or Hillary, so you don't have to start just like, oh my God, I can't stand these people, and no, just stop. But I'm speaking in the spirit here. I'm speaking in the spirit, and I can do that. And Jesus, you know, the centurion said, I'm not worthy that thou mayest, I'm not worthy that you come into my house. Speak the word only, Lord, and my servant shall be healed. So speak the word only, Lord, and deliver these people. Convict them of sin. Convict them of treachery. Convict them of being traitors. Convict them of their shenanigans, because I've warned them twice in two videos. You better stop it, or you're going to bring a curse on yourself. And we just had, you know, like, we just had a little, you know, stocks went down the other day. And the Lord says, okay, stop it, or God forbid, it could be much worse even, okay? So if you have lost money in that, I'm sorry. And protect the innocent people, Lord, from these things. Protect the innocent people from, because sometimes, you know, you got to pray a little bit more when things are happening. Protect the innocent people from the destruction of the curses that they bring on themselves. Let them bring them, if they're going to bring on a curse on themselves, Lord, let it just land on them and them alone. Leave the good people out, Lord. Protect our infrastructure, our phones, our cell phones, our electrical devices. Protect the internet. Protect our connections. Protect our bank accounts. Protect our income. Protect our, the law for us is for us, not against us. We come against lawfare. We bind it on earth. It's bound from heaven. Convict these people, Lord, that are using legal lawfare illegally. I don't care who you are out there. God, convict them. Send your word in the name of Jesus. Protect our military. Protect these young men and women out there in our military. They're not the problem here. But we lift up this, they call it the military industrial complex. Okay. The people up there, if they are using situations in our world for their own devices and their own, oh, I have a home over here in the DC area, and I've got to keep these wars going because I gotta keep paying my mortgages, and I might have five houses somewhere even, or three or two. One might not be enough because, you know, okay, whatever. And then how many people out there, Lord, that are being paid by the government right now that have been ordered to be dishonest? Some of those people are not, they're tired of being lying to the Holy Spirit, lying to God in their conscience. and they're coming forth as whistleblowers. Protect the whistleblowers, Lord. And by the way, I wonder how many demons were thrown out of heaven down here that we have to deal with. We take authority over you, Satan, and your demons right now. There's so many. There are just so many demons down here. But you all get around. You get around, and we bind you. God's going to chain you for 1,000 years, devil. But we chain you right now. We, the church, take authority over you right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We're tired of you causing havoc and pain in people's lives down here, devil. You come to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus Christ came to give us life and life more abundant. And so we receive that life more abundant. And we thank you, God, for your love and your peace and your joy. Touch and bless the precious children. Provide every need, every vitamin, every need, every mineral in their body they need. Every food that they don't get, every food that they can't get to, every food that can't get to them that they need in their body, supernatural, Lord. Just like you did the children of Israel when you provided the manna. Provide manna, Lord, for the children and the people that are starving, God Almighty. And thank you so much, Lord, for allowing me to get on here and talk. I'm sorry, I'm not going to get to the description of everything I talked about here, so... Thank you for watching my videos. God is love, and I love you very much. And have a great day. God bless.